అనగనగా ఒక మహానది.
Darshan came and asked me if I would be willing to guest host an interview, and I readily agreed because the person I'm going to be interviewing now is not just a friend, she's also a colleague, but more importantly, she's one of the most talented young actresses in the country. And it's not just me saying it, she is also the recipient of the Best Actress National Award for the year 2018 for her phenomenal performance in the film Mahanati as Mahanati. Present to you Kirti Suresh. Hi Kirti.
Thank you, Rahul.
How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
It's all a little dizzying, isn't it?
It is. And have you done this before? You seem like...
Interviewing? Yeah. No, my first time. So I'm nervous, but we're all actors, so we do a good job of faking it. So yeah. Kirti, the first thing I wanted to ask you, I know that you come from a very successful film family. Both your parents are veteran artists in their own right. Your dad was a director, your mother was an actress.
Dad is a producer.
Also a director, right?
No.
No? Okay. Dad was a producer, I'm so sorry. And your mother was an actress. And did you stumble upon cinema or did you harbor a passion? Did you want to become an actress?
It was always driven because of passion. I always wanted to become an actor from the time I saw my mom on screen.
Okay.
So that was always there. In fact...
Do you remember when? What age? You remember?
I think... my second standard or third standard.
Okay.
And it's behind a beautiful story that actually my mom, the first movie that she did in Malayalam was called Opal.
Okay.
And she was really expecting a national award at that time for that. And okay. She used to tell her stories of how she lost it and how she didn't get it, and that's when it actually triggered me, like, I should get this for my mom. And that's how it actually all started from, and today I'm sitting with you here.
How sweet.
After the awards, so this is all like her.
What
is
your mom's reaction?
Mom is all on cloud nine and she's super happy.
Right.
And yeah, so it's like, it's actually the word, I mean the phrase dream come true is like,
right.
You know, I feel it has a meaning today.
Right, I can imagine. That's a lovely story. Yeah. I didn't expect that. The reason I started with that was because we worked together, although very briefly. Kirti had done a guest appearance in another film that I directed. And the one thing that stood out for me was how involved you were. You were very, very involved, whatever the take. And I remember how involved you were in dubbing, in getting it right. And the reason I wanted to ask you is, coming from a film family, it would have been easy for you to take things easy, but you didn't. You were very involved. I wanted to understand if that change happened because of Mahanati or if you were very driven from a young age.
Actually,
did Mahanati make you take cinema more seriously?
Definitely. I started feeling more responsible towards my work, towards cinema, after Mahanati.
Right.
Definitely after Mahanati. Till then, I think I didn't get into details too much, but after that I thought I can't give a space for anything to go wrong.
Right.
It has to be on point, so I think Mahanati just changed it completely. I think I'm even more responsible than how I was 3-4 years ago.
And it makes it a pleasure for a director to work with when you have an actor who's so involved.
Thank you.
And who's trying to own what she's doing and make sure she gets it right. That's what you really need. Someone who's motivated on the set. And that was such a pleasure.
Thank you.
Now, here's another interesting thing I want to ask you about Mahanati. We'll start with something very curious and then we'll move on to more cheerful things.
Okay.
I remember when the project was announced, that a lot of eyebrows were raised. Because Kirti at that point, she was this very popular young girl. You know, people took a shine to her. There was a lot of affection for you. And yet you were largely untested as a talent.
Yeah.
If you know what I mean. I don't think you'd gotten a role that allowed you to show people what you were capable of.
Yes.
So when Mahanati was announced and people said Kirti Suresh is going to play Mahanati Savitri, people were like, eh? Okay. I remember there was a very common industry, especially. Did that ever get to you? Did you hear about it? Or did the team insulate you?
No. Fortunately or unfortunately, when I was promoting the movie, is when I got to know when people were asking me the same question, like, how did you feel when this was the reaction? I was like, was that the reaction? I really didn't know. I was so involved in...
Smart of your director to keep you insulated from
Yeah, I didn't even look at the comments or anything which was happening around the movie. All that I remember was, I think, the first day of shoot, one picture leaked, and I knew that at that time that was a point of discussion, like, this can't be the look of her and all that.
Mahanati, and she's very untested, we don't even know if she can act well, what's going on here. I remember there was a very common reaction.
I didn't take too much into me because I didn't even see what was happening around me.
Good you didn't. And the film then came and blew people away, and they were like, wow, I don't think anybody can imagine anybody else as Mahanati now.
Thank you so much.
But what was the process?
Only person who kept me confident throughout the movie was Nagi, my director.
Right.
Otherwise, I was always skeptical. I never knew if I was doing the right thing. And Nagi, after every shot, he's not like, he is very expressive. He's like, ha, ha, ha. I'm like, I think I did a pretty good shot. I think I think you can still react more. He's like, you know, very chilled. He's in his own zone and he's very chilled. So when your director says superb, wow, this, that, you feel like, okay, I think I'm doing a good job. So in Nagi's case, he's not at all expressive. I mean, he's expressive in a very different way. So I just didn't know if I was doing the right thing. But I never, gave up on it. Yeah, because from the beginning, Sunagi gave me a pen drive where there were a lot of Savitri Ma's movies.
Right.
I've watched all her movies before, but these were like very specific, like emotional scenes, humor scenes. So when I used to go and watch them, and we did replicate a few scenes in Mahanati, like Maya
Some
Bazaar.
Iconic scenes.
Yeah. So such scenes is where I had to watch it on loop to see it, to get her exact nuances, and otherwise to get the way Savitri Garu does her style, you can't keep watching it over and over again, because
right.
What happens is you feel like, no, I can't do this, I shouldn't be watching this anymore. Because
right?
How much ever I watch it, if you ask me to do something which I did in my first take, for the second take I'll be like, what did I do?
Right.
And if you ask a third person to do what another person has done, and it's completely different, right?
That
so,
fine line between mimicking and acting and creating it yourself.
Yeah. So it used to be very difficult to replicate, and the challenge was how to show her on screen as a person who she was not on screen.
Right.
Like behind how
right.
she was as
was
a person.
Right.
Because I've not met her, I don't know her. So I spoke to her daughter Vijay Chamundeshwari Garu, and got a lot of tips from her. She said a lot of things which actually kind of matched between us. Like, she's a good swimmer.
Okay.
I swim pretty well. Some reaction, we do this to scare kids away.
Right? Yeah,
so she does that. Such small, small things. So it was very surprising in the beginning when she told me. I was like, okay, there are some things which are matching. And on top of all, I think the way we walk is very similar.
Okay.
Because Vijaya Garu, she came to the set and she's like, the way you walk is also just like Amma. I was like,
really?
That is the way I walk.
We thought you had put in effort.
Okay, now then I shouldn't be saying this.
Don't.
So a lot of things. So it was it was definitely a challenge. Definitely, she was not like a new person to me. We had always known her.
Right.
And now that I know her more.
You are her.
Okay, thank you.
The second part of the question, I want to understand, I'm very fascinated about it. See, you're recreating an era where the acting meter was very different.
Mm.
It was theater driven. And the audiography back in those times necessitated actors to shout a little more, therefore your expressions were also a little louder. The acting meter was very different. Was there a conscious decision to say, no, we'll replicate that same meter in the scenes where you were in front of the camera as Savitri? Or did you say that, you know, let's sort of abandon
so
that?
So this was my very first doubt, which I asked my director.
Mm.
So I asked him, so the acting meter those days were different. So very. What do you want me to do? Do you... So this...
Because it can become farcical.
Yeah. So I asked him, so when we portray Savitri Garu as a person, like in her, you know, real life, should that meter be a little up?
Right.
I asked him this question. He said, no, it's not necessary. Like as a person, she wouldn't be like how she's on screen.
Correct.
Right? So we don't need that.
But on screen? He wanted you to replicate.
So on screen, replicate. And you know, because Vijaya Garu told me a lot of nuances like about her mannerisms. So I just took those to, you know, like how do I explain? For example, apparently she wets her lips before every shot.
Okay.
So if you see in the Mahanati song, at one place, before he clicks a picture of mine, I think for the Lux photo shoot, we replicated, I'll do this.
Very.
So it is... It
fascinating.
Is, so it's just about... We just tried to incorporate her mannerisms here and there, the way she walks, small things, the way she does with her lips, she does the same.
Right.
That's
of course,
there in the beginning.
Of course.
So, just put all the mannerisms together and, you know, it forms a character at the end.
People might argue that it's not important, but the character starts beginning to, the character begins to feel more lived in.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's more detailed.
Yeah.
You see those little details and that's when
exactly.
you're able to buy the fact that this is someone.
Exactly.
Right?
So, in the beginning, I was very confused as, what's a personality like? How will I bring in that character? So, when you read a mannerism.
So when he gave you the pen drive, did he also ask you to do homework on what she was like off screen? Or, you know, did you by yourself take an effort?
No, he didn't ask me to do anything.
No?
He didn't ask me to, he only asked me to do the movie. That's
okay.
all. Because in the beginning, I think, you know, when he narrated the script, I said, no, I'm not doing this movie. So they
really?
Were, yeah, I said, I rejected the offer because I was scared. Like, you know, I didn't know like how... because
I didn't know that. Thank God she didn't. She didn't reject it. I mean,
because this it's all positive today and it's all like good things around me.
It was a bit daunting back then.
But I never thought this is going to happen. It was all I had. It was haunting me in a different way. So.
Oh, I can totally imagine.
Yeah. So I said no, and then Nagi was so confident. He was like. I can see you doing the young portion, the old portion, especially the young portion, which is why I think he narrated it to me. And I asked him, why me? I had the question, why me? Because I don't know, like, out of all the other people, why me?
Yeah.
So later, when we were doing the movie, he was telling me, I don't know, he saw this Tamil movie of mine with Dhanush Sarath called Todari.
Of course.
He saw a song from that and he was like, I liked your eyes.
I was about to guess that it must have been the eyes.
Yeah, I don't know. I was like, okay, fine. I mean, so he had a vision.
Right.
So thanks to Nagi, otherwise I don't think we'll be sitting and talking here.
Right.
And then he pushed and he said, you can do it. It'll be nice. I thought, okay, if somebody else is feeling so much confident on me, then why not myself? I think I should give it a try. And yeah,
so, there was no brief from Nagi whatsoever as to wanting to replicate how Savitri Garu was off screen?
No, it was more like I used to shoot a lot of questions to Nagi.
Okay.
More than him. Like, he's very chill. I was like, am I doing the right job that he seems so confident, or is he unhappy?
Or is he just given up then?
Yeah, that he's so unhappy that he's given up. So that's how he reacts, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah. But
no, but I, whatever little I know of him, of the few interactions I've had with him, I sense a guy who has a very silent conviction, who knows what he's doing, and who knows how to get the job done.
Yeah, exactly.
So.
But you don't know that, right? You're working with him the first time, and that now that I'm used to him, I know. The next time I work with him, I know, okay, this is what he is.
Right. Moving on from Mahanati, I mean, so many accolades around the world. It's done so well in so many film festivals around the world, and today the National Award, the icing on the cake. It can't not have an impact on how you choose your future films.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's sort of like a cloud over all your decisions,
it's
right?
It's a big responsibility.
It is. And you can't escape the fact that you did this film, it became a runaway success, and there's so much respect. Do you at all feel scared to go do a song and dance routine in two scenes in a big film now, or?
Definitely. I mean, as I told you, I feel more responsible now, and even if you do a small character or a song or whatever, you definitely feel like, you know, you need that importance,
right?
Even if it's in a big movie. And I think after this, I think the offers that come our way are also pretty much
thankfully.
Yeah, thankfully. So
it takes that one visionary director to see in you that nobody else has seen.
Yeah.
And then people will follow suit. They'll be like, no, Kirti will handle it. So I get it, I understand. But I mean, see, you're also someone who's doing big tentpole films on the other hand. So are you now sort of consciously asking directors that you want to have a more active role, and rather than a passive role, in how the story moves forward, how your character affects the story, or are you just politely saying no to those films, or?
Like I said, I have not gotten any offers that, you know, where I have not gotten any offers like that, but you get more women-centric films,
right?
Which is actually very scary.
This is a personal opinion. Until a bunch of you girls come out and hammer down that glass ceiling and prove to people that, listen, you invest money on films that are centered around us, we can make that money back for you. Until a bunch of you girls, like Samantha does it today, you're doing it today, Nayantara's there and Tamil doing it, we need that tribe. You know, there are a bunch of us who are thinking of these stories, right? And every time we think of a woman-centric film, the first thing we ask ourselves is, who do I go and put this, I mean, whose shoulders do I go put this on? Who will be able to carry this burden?
Yeah.
And until a bunch of you come in, it's initially it's going to be very difficult, but thankfully there's a bunch of you girls doing it, and
I think
a bunch of us
a
guys
few years down the lane that is going to happen,
right. So it's no more, finally I think we've gotten to a stage where people have stopped using the word woman-centric film. You never say man-centric film, right?
Yeah, you do.
So why say woman-centric film? I think
it's very new. It's just started happening.
Now, not anymore. Thankfully, last 3-4 years
have been very good.
With your, you know, from your O Baby to a Mahanati to, you know, a bunch of films that have come out where you girls have carried the film on your shoulders, and these films have seen box office returns. So my request as both a director who thinks up of stories and as someone who goes to a theater to watch films is, please stick to it. I'm not saying don't do the big tentpole films with the big stars. Sure, you can balance that out, but don't feel scared. We trust in you. I'd love for girls like you with the talent, with the box office confidence now to go do films like that. And I think it's great for Indian cinema. And I think it's great for us storytellers, where we don't have to limit ourselves in terms of how we're thinking of our leading women in a film. That we're not scared to write films around them. I'd end with the one question which you probably have been asked in a bunch of interviews before, but one of the early scenes in the film where the left eye tear, right? Have you been asked that question in every single interview?
Yeah.
Okay. I still need to know. I've heard that it actually did happen with Savitri Garu. So did Nagi give you any references on whether it actually happened? What?
Yeah, it actually happened. It's there in the book also.
Uh-huh.
He gave me a book, I read that. It's there in the book. When we shot for the scene, I actually made everyone wait for 2 hours, and I made it happen the way you saw.
It was worth it.
Yeah, because I was like, if Savitri Garu has done it, you know, like, if that was the talent that she was portraying, and I shouldn't be using glycerin. And I didn't use glycerin, and I made them wait for 2 hours. But we got the shot, but that felt like, okay, I did something good.
Right.
If I had just, you know, finished it with one little glycerin and just gone, I mean, it would have been much easier, but I wouldn't have felt satisfied. This made me feel more satisfied.
Personally, as someone who watched the film, loved the film, I think where I got sold on Kirti Suresh being Savitri, I said, whoa, this girl's got something. She's nailing it, is that scene.
It
was just very beautifully staged. It was beautifully scored, I remember. And it was so beautifully acted out by you that I think, to me, when I was watching the film, that's the exact moment where I got sold, saying,
thank you.
Okay, this girl's a good actress and she's Savitri, I can buy it. So yeah, congratulations once again.
Thank you. And congrats to you too. Look who's talking. He's got for best screenplay, Sheila Su. Congrats, Rahul.
Thank you,
and,
Casey. Thank you.
It was a pleasure work. I've done only one movie with you for one
just two
day.
Days. Yeah.
One and a half days. I want to do a complete movie with
we
you.
Should. I really do
we
look
should,
forward
we
to
should.
It.
We should. I'm looking forward.
All you directors watching, there are very few around who are as involved as she is. And I've been very lucky to work with quite a few actors like that. And she's definitely one of them. It was such a pleasure. So please write incredible stories for her, because she can pull it off. She can pull it off.
Thank
Such you. Such a pleasure, Kirti. We won't keep you any longer. And congratulations once again.
Thank you, Rahul. Thank you.